In the previous videos, we already saw about how to generate a video as well as I explained to you about the workspace. So in this video, I'll be explaining you about presets as well as the other settings that you can use to create your video. So first thing is you'll be having this option over here. So this is called as presets. And if you click on manage, you'll be seeing different styles over here, and each preset will have a theme, color, lighting and a vibe. For example, if I go to this cardboard, this has also the same properties. So let me explain to you why this preset is used. So imagine you want to generate a lot of images but with a specific theme. So for example, let's say you want to generate a video and you want all the characters in that video to be 3D and you want the color theme to be like light brown or something. In that case, rather than adding that particular text in each and every prompt that you are using, you can just add it as a preset. And when generating that video, you can just select that particular preset and you can just write your prompt alone rather than specifying the theme, lighting and looks. It just helps us to minimize writing the same conditions and properties for each prompt, and rather than that, we can just store it here. For example, by default, Sora offers these 5 presets, alright? So let me go with one example. For example, this cardboard and paper craft. Here they have specified the theme as cardboard and color to be brown and stuff, lighting as soft. So whatever the video that we generate by using that preset, that will be themed like a cardboard. For example, let me click on done. So for selecting a preset, go here and by default it will be in none. And for this demo purpose, I will just select cardboard. And after selecting that, I will just give my prompt. So this is the video that I got, and it's not perfect, but you get the theme, right? The theme kind of looks like cardboard, the trees and the car, the road, it looks like cardboard. It's made up of cardboard. So that's what the theme means. And by this way, you can also specify many other things like lighting as well as the color grading in that video. For example, let me go and create a custom preset. For doing that, you want to click on this, go to manage, and you can just click on this plus icon and you can type a new preset. So I'll just go with demo 1, and here we can specify camera, lighting, the colors and everything. So in my case, I will just go with a simple one. I will just go with theme. Theme is going to be the objects or the surroundings, how it needs to appear in your video. So I'll just go with 3D. The theme is going to be 3D and cartoonish, something like this. And let me go with the color. Let me just have it as bright and vibrant, something like this. And let me just save this. You can delete and edit it at any time. So I will just save. Yeah, it has been created and done. And now I'll just go and select my preset and let me just type in a prompt. So this is the video that I am creating. My preset was 3D and cartoonish, but the video has been bad, but you get the context, right? I need to give more prompting over there. So it's 3D and it's colorful, bright and vibrant. So that's basically the preset thing. And apart from that, next is going to be the aspect ratio, which is 16:9 by default, the YouTube one. And another one is going to be the 1:1. I will also show a demo of how 1:1 looks. So this is the 1:1 ratio. It's basically like a square. And next, let me go with 9:16, which is like the TikTok format. And this is how the 9:16 aspect ratio looks. And next we have the image quality. So I am using the plus plan. So I get only 720p as well as 480p, which is $20 plan. And if you want to use the 1080p quality, you need to make sure that you are getting the pro plan, which is $200 per month. And next is the duration. So as a plus user, I have access to 10 seconds and 5 seconds for 480p. So if I change this to 720p, I can only generate 5 seconds. And if you want to get 20 or 15 seconds, you need to go with the pro version. But 480p comes with 10 seconds also, but 720 just 5 seconds. And next is the number of videos. Similar case, 720p, I get 1 video and 2 video. I can do 4 videos in 720p in plus users. And if I go with 480p, I am able to generate 4 videos over there for 480p. And this question mark is the number of credits which will be used. For example, 480p and 1 video for 5 seconds cost only 25. But if I go with 480p and 10 seconds, it costs 50. So based upon the settings that you put, the more number of credits will be charged. That's the video, guys. In the upcoming videos, I will be explaining you about the storyboard as well as how to upload your own image and videos. Check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.